is so multifaceted and means so many things. It looks like so many different things. It's like kind of too important. It's meant a lot to me, to my survival, to the love of Black women, Black femmes, queer people, trans folk. I owe my life to immigrants, I owe my life to indigenous people, I owe my life to the water, I owe my life to this breath, to you, to all of you that continue to do this on purpose. My mother, Billy, also thank you for a beautiful, beautiful set. So much. Moms. I love my mom. She's my everything, almost to the point that I've lost myself. And I'm going through a process right now of kind of on, what's that word? Unraveling and kind of leaving my mother in ways, recognizing the ways in which I've clung and she's clung and we've clung for centuries, searching for the love that we, and I say we, and I mean a lot of different identities, but particularly the feminine, has clung to any bit of love that we could possibly get, any bit of nourishment that we could possibly get, and a lot of the time that comes in the form of our daughters and our children. And I'm realizing now that I'm letting go of a lot of the pain and a lot of the trauma that wasn't actually mine to begin with. Realizing what's mine and what isn't mine. And it's incredibly empowering and so fucking painful. Oh my God. So this is a moment of that. A few months ago, my mother and I were sent to a spiritual healer. Her name, Free Woman, paints us her travels over guava juice and warm cake. We spin questions into the air around us, call on the unseen for wisdom. We are told we have been mother and daughter for many lives before this. Roles reversing, saving, being saved. This does not surprise me. The way we become our mothers anyways. Free Woman then tells me what I already know, that my chest is a clogged sink. The trauma of my bloodline clot the piping black tar and matted hair calcified over generations. This does not surprise me. The asthmatic, the sticky cough, the windless instrument I am told to focus on my breathing, to prioritize, to carve room for myself in my own chest, and what a foreign practice it is, breathing for my own sake. The children of displacement know who their future belongs to long before the college application. No sacrifice has birthplace. Taught always to come home, taught them especially. Taught this is how she ought to wear a spine, shoulders back, magic tightly coiled, pinned and pinned, chin just low enough to wear a man, but high enough to slip out of him. In university, I learned the word patriarchy, learned the word systemic, learned the acronym FGM, PTSD, ADHD, and tried to fit the broken of everyone I've known into tiny, transparent capsule. I teach my mother my new words. She is studying social work, listens to audiobooks on mindfulness, on quelling the storm in her throat, interrogates the experience fermenting inside her, attempts to clear the piping in her own chest, water it down, flush it out, learns her own new words like toxic, like accountability, like boundaries, names her abuse. But when I begin to name my own, scrape up the courage to use my whole mouth to say queer, say fluid, say sex and freedom and holy in the same breath. I watch how fear melts her back down to sacrifice, birthplace, how quickly her face mirrors the tar still remaining, how shut off, how self-respect and all its slut-shaming friends howl at me through her gaping mouth. For a moment, she's everyone else's hoyo. For a moment, she's everyone else's mouth, and I see how complicated the plumbing be. How winding the road, how intricate the stitch of teaching centuries thick. She asks me about God, if we've spoken. If this has anything to do with my father, that it isn't fair to condemn half a species based on the action, or the inaction of one, and I say, but ain't that been Eve's story? Gaia's, melanin's, I ask who I ought to be fair to, if not myself. I ask who I ought to condemn, who I ought to allow a flimsy, conditional, binary love in, if not myself. And her face softens. And she asks why my freedom's so loud. And I asks and asks how I could say love and cause her so much grief. Showers me in what ifs that leave her childless. And I answer. The trauma shows its face in the way we hold and let go of fear. I grab her hands. Trace the lineage holding her together compared to my own, saying what I've said to my father, that her child is tired, that she is breathing. I thank her as her daughter, as her mother, as a witness to her mutability to my own. I belt the word no in two small rooms, and she follows. Singing wherever she can find the breath. And it is enough for me. The breath is enough.